Welcome back, Pokemon fans. My name is Angel of the Night 091, and today we're going to kick it off with a brand new Let's Play. We're going to be going through the Paldea region in Pokemon Scarlet. Now, this morning, November 18th, I woke up, hopped out to my GameStop, and luckily my pre-ordered copy was available. So I got the double pack of Pokemon Scarlet and Pokemon Violet. This is pretty exciting, guys, because quite frankly, this is going to be an amazing game. Luckily, I had the capability of playing it before the release date, which is awesome. We are going to jump into this Let's Play. Now, one thing I want to do is I want to go through and catch them all. So we're going to go through and try to catch every Pokemon that's available in the Paldea region. So we're going to go in and choose our character here. Now, in the previous copy that I played of Scarlet, I chose the female character because, I mean, pretty obvious reasons. The trainer customizations are a whole lot better for the female characters usually. I'm going to see what the male trainers are going to be capable of. So let's go ahead here. We're going to choose... Let's choose this trainer here. We're going to put our name in here for the Let's Play. I'm going to put my first name. You guys all know it. My first name is Corey. I could have probably put Angel of the Night or Angel, but... we'll just go with my first name. Way easier. So, the trainer customization is quite impressive here at the beginning because they didn't really give you this option in any of the other generations. So, as you can see here, we've got the standard shortcut, typical side braid, side fade, which is actually kind of cool. It's actually kind of an interesting haircut. You haven't seen these in the other games. There's the short bob, obviously not going for that. There's the long and straight. The side part, which is actually not that bad. It's not that bad, actually. Slicked back, probably an okay choice. What's the long bob? I think I'll skip the long bob. Definitely not the ponytail. Not really feeling it. I wish they would give you the option for a beard, but I guess at this point you're probably, like, what, the age of 10 or 12? But the pompadour... I don't think I'm going to go with the pompadour. Although it looks kind of cool. Looks kind of cool. It got the shave back going on. Short crop. Two standard. There's the pixie cut. Two block cut. That one's not that bad, actually. It's kind of similar to what I have there going on up top. Of course, you know, I've got a little bit more hair this time in this Let's Play. On the sides. Haven't got the haircut yet. We got the bowl cut. Oh my gosh. You kind of look like some Stranger Things things going on here. Stranger Things kids. No thanks. Space bun. Nope. There's the dreadlocks. There's the asymmetrical bob. Or the crop. Crop's not that bad. I think I'm going to go with the two block cut. So we're going to go with that. We're going to go over to the coloring now. You've got your black. You got your gold. Dark brown. Your ash brown. Your light brown. Platinum blonde, you got your pink, your reds, your greens, your whites. I mean, I could probably go with the white. There's a little bit more white in my beard this time here, now that I'm doing the Let's Play, since the last time I was on camera for Let's Plays. There's the pink, there's the blue, there's red, smoky pink, blue-green, lavender, violet, there's scarlet, there's silver, the ash purple, which actually is not that bad. The ash purple looks kind of cool. Blonde, the green. Ooh, the dark denim. That actually looks kind of cool. Denim blue. It's not a bad blue. Light denim. Nope. I'm pretty sure we can change this later on, but I kind of want to go with the ash purple for some reason. Let's go with something that's gonna pop. There's the silver, scarlet, that's a little too red for me. There's the violet, lavender, blue green's kinda neat. Oh, decisions, guys, decisions. Let's go with Let's go with the dark denim blue. Gosh. Game Freak, why did you give us this ability to choose our Pokemon trainer colors? I think I'm going to go with my first instinct. I'm going to go with the Ash Purple. Let's just do it. Let's go with that style. Now let's go for changing of the look. So you can actually go through and change your eye shapes here. I don't really think there's a whole lot of options that I want to go with. The blue-gray is probably the best option for the eye colors. No, let's leave. Ooh, light blue is really cool. There's the gray. The gray is probably a really good idea. Lavender? Yeah, let's go with the lavender eye color. Okay, eyelashes. No, I don't think I'm gonna go with any of that. What? Kind of makes you think of the band Kiss, you know, the face paints and all that. Let's see. Nope. I think I'll just go with the standard. I think let's just do that. What did I choose for the hair color? Ash purple? I think I'll just stick with the eyebrows. Ash purple. We'll just stay with black. It's fine. There we go. Oh, cool. You can add freckles. I don't have any freckles, so we're not going to worry about that. Yeah, we're going to go with this look. And ready. Okay. First thing I want to do is I want to turn off autosave, because that's not really how I play. I'm not really the autosave kind of fella. Naranja Academy. Taking lessons from tradition, growing stronger and greater. It's time for you to dive into the world of Pokemon. Director Clavel? I'll go Clavel. We'll call it Clavel. Head of Naranja Academy. Paldea is a sprawling region bursting with lush nature and magnificent landscapes. It is also, of course, home to the mysterious creatures known to us as Pokemon. They reside here in great numbers, in fact. Pokemon can be found living all over, in the seas, in the skies, even our cities and towns. We humans coexist with Pokemon, as we both help one another to live and thrive. Naranja Academy is here to help you learn even more about these precious partners. Within our halls, people from all regions gather to study together. And as Pokemon trainers, they have their Pokemon do battle, growing alongside them. While our robust curriculum of coursework helps our students draw forth their fullest potential, It is within these halls that you will find your friends, your Pokemon. We, the facility and staff at Naranja Academy, can't wait to welcome you with open arms. All right, guys, let's get into this LP. Very beginning scene, already getting the goosebumps, already getting the shivers right down my whole body. Definitely feels epic right off the bat. It's just a feeling that you get as soon as you play this game. You just get absolutely hooked on this game. I am speaking from some experience. I do have a little bit of time with this game. So I'm pretty happy about it. Pretty happy about this game. I'm really excited. Now, with that being said, even though this is a brand new game, this is a Let's Play series, I do have my competitive series already on the side. So luckily I've actually got like a good chunk of time into it. So I'm actually working on breeding some teams right now. So hopefully competitive will be pretty quick with this channel, or at least I'm hoping anyways. One thing I have to say is I don't think I can be any happier right now than right this minute. I've got 2 weeks vacation. I took 2 weeks vacation off from work, and all I plan to do is just sit and record this LP, edit it, upload it, give you guys some pretty awesome content. So here we are into the game. It's got a very Sword and Shield vibe right off the bat, but the audio is where it's at. The audio in this game is actually pretty good. Very peaceful, in fact. So we want to go into the settings here. So you do that by going to your X button onto your controls, and then you just want to go down to where it says autosave. Now use the D-pad, of course, to switch it to off, and then A to confirm. So the biggest thing with this is that we want to turn off the autosave, because one of the biggest issues with Sword and Shield when it first came out is the autosaves would corrupt and then you would lose your game saves. So one thing I don't want to do is lose any game saves here. So we are going to go through the room here. As you can see, you've got your map onto the wall, which I don't believe is clickable at this point. I don't think you can actually view it, but the amount of detail that's in this room, if we can take a moment and just look at the carpet, there's a lot of different textures that you can see right off the bat in this game, and it only gets better as you go. So there you go, you got a little Squovit pillow, Krogunk. Of course, you got your posters, you got your bed, you got your hat and backpack. Let's go downstairs and visit Mom. Oh, Mom, where are you at? Hey, it's a Squovit. Must be the family Squovit. So if we take a look here, we got a couple boxes. You got a couple rooms you can't get into. They've definitely tried to capture the region's setting with all the bright colors in this game. Like, if you actually take where it's based off in the world, I can't remember what country they said it was, but it definitely has some really overseas vibes going on right now. Good morning, Corey. Oh, already in uniform and everything. Well, it is your first day at your new school, after all. I'm so excited for you. Still, you might want to cool your engines before you go racing out the door. The school contacted me and said that you're supposed to wait here a little while longer. Their words, not mine. Apparently, there's something very important for your first day that still hasn't arrived. Who could that be? Maybe that's the very thing we're waiting for. Corey, get the door, would you? Right on. I'll go get the door. Come on, Squovit. Let's go get that door. Do forgive the intrusion. You are Master Corey, yes? On behalf of the Academy, I must apologize for the late arrival of your enrollment documents. Ah, and also for my delay in introducing myself. I am the director of Naranja Academy. You may call me Mr. Clavel. Clavel. I'll call him Clavel. I don't know how to pronounce these names, guys. It's the very first time really trying to pronounce them. The director, and you came in person to help my son with his first day? Well, I am responsible for the entire academy, including any failure on this part. So here at last are the enrollment documents that should have already been delivered to you. Goodness, you really needn't have. Since you've come all this way, can I at least offer you a cup of tea? Ah, no need to trouble yourself. Corey. Oh, that's Mom. Gotta change my voice. Corey, I've got a thing or two to discuss with the director here. Why don't you head back up to your room and finish getting ready for school? You'll need your bag and your hat as well. Now, Mr. Clavel, we'll call him Clavel. You simply must join me for a cuppa. A cuppa? Well, how can I refuse such a kind offer? Alright, let's go get our hat and our bag. I wish we could have done that at the beginning. The thing with this game is it's a little slow to walk around at the beginning, just because you can't really run. You don't have, like, the running shoes yet, which, by the way, do not really exist. It just somehow starts to unlocking for you that you can actually start moving around, which is pretty cool. So let's get our hat and our bag. First thing I want to do is I want to get rid of that hat. I don't think I can do that yet. Okay. What a dorky hat. Can I just grow this beard out? Like, that'd be fantastic. Oh, just look at you. All ready for your big first day. Yes, the uniform of our storied academy suits you quite well indeed. Oh gracious, how very careless of me. I had entirely forgotten. But your living room is hardly the place for it. Would you care to follow me outside? I'm pretty sure this is where they're going to give you your starter Pokemon. I wonder what this important thing might be. Let's follow the director out and see, shall we? All right, let's go out and check on the director. Right then, dear Pokemon. Time to come out of your Pokeballs. We provide each student entering the academy a Pokemon of their own. I'll ask you to choose which among these three you'd like to have as your partner. Sprigatito, the Grass Cat Pokemon. Fuey Coco, the Fire Croc Pokemon. And Quaxly, the Duckling Pokemon. They're all very good company. Why they usually refuse to even leave my side. What's this? So it turns out they're more interested in you, Master Corey, than familiar old me. I do wish I could stay and see which one you'll choose, but I must be off to my next home visit. I'll be at the house just over there. Take your time with your decision. Then come find me once your mind is made up. Now, if you'll excuse me, until next we meet. What a mannerly fellow that director of yours is. These three are all lovely, but you need to choose just one, right? Not an easy task. Why not take this opportunity to walk about with these little ones and get to know them? I'm sure they have lots to teach you. Oh, but before you go, I got you a little something to celebrate your big day. Take it with you if you're going out on your own. All right, we got the Rotom phone. Now we can make some phone calls, use some apps. It's a brand new phone. According to the instructions, you can check the map app by pressing the Y button. It'll help you from getting lost, so take good care of the new gadget, okay? Now off you go, have fun. So one thing I have to say with the Rotom phone, I really hope I don't have to enroll it in Intune. If you guys know what Intune is, you get the joke. Said that just for you, Ron. I know you're watching. So we're gonna walk around here with our starter Pokemon. We get to choose which one we want to take as our starter. Now, I did choose the Spirigatito already in another game. So I think this time what I want to do is I want to go with the Fuecoco. And the reason being is I'm always more so a fire-type Pokemon fan than grass. However, in the last couple of games, I did choose the grass starters. So I took, like, I chose Grookey and I chose Spirigato already. Oh my gosh, it's going to take me a little bit to get used to the names. So Spirigatito, I think it was. I definitely don't want to choose it again. Now, I know everybody's going pretty wild over the cat, and I don't blame them. The cat's a pretty cool starter. Quaxly is another cool Pokemon as well. However, I'm not really big on water starter Pokemon. The only one that I've really been big on was like Totodile back in the day. So I think I'm just going to bypass the water starter altogether. Now, if you can take a look here, as we actually go through here, they've actually got the textures down pretty good. Like, take a look at that grass there. That grass, you can see, definitely have some blades. I wish the bushes had a little bit more detail into them, but I mean, one thing that you'll notice is that you'll actually be able to walk through the bushes rather than getting stopped, which is kind of neat. You haven't really been able to do that in past games. Usually if there's a bush or a tree in the way, you usually get stuck. So it's really just the trees. So we're actually going to go down a little ways here. We're going to go down to this house down here. I think that's where he said his next home visit was. So we're going to walk down here. It's a little slow. Now, one thing you're going to notice as well that's a little bit different from the past generation games is that when you walk up to a sign, you see how it just automatically populates what it's called? So this is Cabo Poco, which I don't really know what that stands for. However, I'm not worried about it. This is Cabo Poco. It's not much, just a little pinch of community, but it's home. So as you can see, as soon as you get past that gate, you're actually able to walk. So the power of science is amazing. If you connect with friends, you can head out on adventures together, up to four of you at a time. Okay, so I already know what I'm going to choose. As you can see here, the starter Pokemon just kind of follow you around at the beginning. Just that way you get kind of a handle as to which ones they are. Now, if we go up through the gates here, we should meet up with the... I was going to say professor, but he's not your professor. He's your director. So he's your school director. All right, we got Quaxly splashing around in the water there, fixing his do. Spirigatito sniffing the flowers. Definitely a typical grass type Pokemon. And then of course we've got Fuecoco, and he is a hungry little bugger. He's gonna toast everything, eat it up, eat it all, that crispy goodness. Maybe we can use him to like toast up some sandwiches or something later. Whoa! Camera's out of focus, guys. I apologize. Should come back in here in just a moment. There we go. I might be a little too far away from my lens. I don't know why. There we go. Clear it up. That's the only downside with using a DSLR as your webcam. The 15 millimeter lens, if you're too close or too far away, it can interact a little bit. You kind of have to be that happy medium. Buenas. We haven't met, have we? I must say, I wasn't expecting to see you here quite so soon. Hang on, director. Is this who I think it is? Yes. This is our academy's newest student, Master Corey. He will be attending as of today. So you're that kid that moved up the road. I've been dying to find out more about you. I'm Nimona. Normally, I live in the school dorms, but home is here. What do you say, new neighbor? Want to be friends? Oh, hell yeah. You seem cool. Love that enthusiasm. We're going to get along just fine. Miss Nimona is president of our student council and a champion-ranked trainer in her own right. I absolutely love Pokemon battling. In fact, we should battle right now, you and me. Easy now. You two will be in the same class, so you'll have plenty of time to battle later. And get to know one another better, of course. We're going to be neighbors and classmates? Nice. We'll be able to battle all we want. On that note, Master Corey, have you decided which of these Pokemon you would like to be your first partner? All right, guys, this is the defining moment here. We get to choose our starter Pokemon. So as I said, I did choose the Grass Cat already, Spirigatito, in another game. So this time I'm going to go with Fuecoco. So we're going to jump right into it here. We're going to grab our fire starter Pokemon, Fuecoco. The burning hot sparks it scatters will fry any and all plants in a flash. Would you like to go with our good fire type Pokemon, Fuecoco, here? Oh yeah, let's go with Fuecoco. Do I want to give it a nickname? Absolutely not. I'm not a nicknaming kind of person. We're not going to give them any kind of nicknames in this LP. That's pretty cool. I hear its evolution is pretty neat. Fuecoco seems to have taken quite a liking to you, Master Corey. This is your first Pokemon, yes? Please raise it with love and care. And of course, be sure to keep it tucked safely inside a Pokeball. Corey, I can't believe you actually chose Fuecoco. I mean, like, way to make the perfect choice for you. You two make such a good combo. Can I choose one of these Pokemon too, Director Clavel? Oh, but did you not receive a Pokemon when you entered the Academy, Miss Nimona? Not back then, no. I had other Pokemon I was focused on raising at the time. But now I want to raise a new Pokemon alongside Corey, while he raises his own new partner. Indeed, a rather splendid idea. If you wish to raise one of these Pokemon to be on equal footing with Master Corey here, I shall be more than happy to allow it. Yes! Since Corey chose Fuecoco, I'll go for this little one. Nice to meet you, Sprigatito. Welcome to the team. All right, then. Now that we've chosen our Pokemon, we have to battle. I'll be waiting for you down at the beach. Come join me when you're ready. As you may have noticed, Miss Nimona is a tad overly fond of Pokemon battling. But I do hope you'll join her for a battle. It will help you get to know your Pokemon as well. Alright guys, so that is going to be it of this Let's Play here. for episode one. So if you guys enjoyed the video, go ahead and hit that thumbs up. Be sure to post your comments in the comment section below. Which Pokemon are you most excited to see in this Let's Play without gaining spoilers to any of the other players? If you're further ahead, don't share out something that someone else hasn't seen at this point, please. This game is too good to spoil it for everybody else. All right, guys, take care, have a good one, and I'll catch you guys in the next Let's Play Adventure Episode 2. Coming soon, right after this.